having China in charge of the world would be very different than we have now.
At this point, Apple is in no sense American. Apple's loyalty is to the government of China. And if you think that's an overstatement, consider this. Earlier this month, Apple did the bidding of the Chinese government to crush domestic protests against the Communist Party there. Apple did this by disabling its permanent airdrop feature in China, and so far only in China. It's the only country in which it's disabled. So why did Apple disable that feature in China? Well, because that feature, permanent airdrop, allows iPhone users to communicate directly with one another without using the internet or cellular networks, both of which, in a totalitarian state like China, are controlled by the government. And that means that without permanent airdrop, it's effectively impossible for freedom-minded citizens to organize with one another. They're powerless. It would have the scale to control a lot of the world's economy and trade routes and raw materials. It could project military force that, posturing aside, we actually don't have the power to stop. If Russia and China ever got together, it would be a brand new world, and the United States would be greatly diminished. Most Americans agree that would be bad. Now, as Donald Trump predicted very clearly, that is happening. Thanks to Joe Biden's reckless and self-destructive response to the invasion of Ukraine a year ago this week, the economies of Russia and China are intertwined. Chinese spending on Russian goods has increased by more than 60%. China now imports more coal from Russia than it has in the last 5 years. Chinese shipments to Russia, meanwhile, are up by nearly 30%. Companies like Ford and Toyota pulled out of Russia. They had to, remember that? So what happened next? Chinese automakers stepped in. Chinese car makers once made less than 10% of all cars bought in Russia. Now China makes a third of them. And you can see where this is going. The same thing has happened with smartphones and countless other consumer goods. Not surprisingly, the Chinese yuan is replacing the dollar in Moscow. Chinese currency now accounts for fully one-fifth of all trades on the Moscow Stock Exchange. That's up from less than 1% last year. So these are deep and growing economic ties, and they're formal. The thing about economic ties, however, is that they lead inexorably to military ties.
Whenever you connect to the internet on a public Wi-Fi network at airports, coffee shops, friends' houses, or even at your own home, your data is at risk of being stolen and spied on. That's why we recommend and use Private Internet Access. Private Internet Access helps protect your personal data by encrypting your internet connection through their world-class server infrastructure, which makes your information shielded and bulletproof. Private Internet Access has had an audit done conducted by a Big Four firm, as they know VPN use is tied to trust, letting you be sure their 100% no logs policy is safe and secure. Streaming services such as Netflix, Amazon Prime, Disney Plus, and more have different library options based on where you are located, and some shows cannot be accessed if you are not located in the region. Private Internet Access helps you overcome these restrictions by giving you the option to change your IP address to one of their 91 countries to choose from, and all 50 US states, allowing you to gain access to websites and services that are only available in those locations. Private Internet Access is available for all platforms, and you can use one Private Internet Access subscription to protect an unlimited amount of devices at the same time. Get 83% off plus 4 months free of Private Internet Access using our link for a limited time. Click the link in the description or visit piavpn.com/anonymousofficial and protect all your devices.
So China is buying up land across the country, including ag land, but some states, this is so perverse it's hard to believe it's real, are helping the Chinese government replace American manufacturing as well. The governor of Michigan, Gretchen Whitmer, just gave more than $700 million in taxpayer money to fund a massive Chinese battery plant in Big Rapids, Michigan. Residents there are protesting. This is one of the stories, it's hard to believe it's real. How could Gretchen Whitmer have gotten away with this?
Well, how did she get away with this? But how is it not a bigger story what we've recently found out? Because we gave the state of Michigan, lawmakers and Gretchen Whitmer have decided to give this company $715 million in taxpayer dollars. But in the company bylaws that are on the company website, it clearly states that when they get to Michigan, they have to have a CCP organization on site, a Chinese Communist Party organization on site, a propaganda arm of the CCP right in the center of the country in Michigan, 1 square mile of CCP in the center of Michigan, and that has to influence the grassroots of the corporation. So think about that. They have to have the CCP there. This is in the bylaws. Clearly, the lawmakers and Gretchen Whitmer read these bylaws. You would have to say, you would have to know what the company's operations are going to be. This is nowhere near any of our car manufacturers, any of our automobile manufacturers. So what exactly are they doing in this rural area in Michigan? But to top it off, we now know that about 250 to 300 will be housed at the local university there, Chinese nationals. These are not going to be American jobs. They're bringing Chinese nationals in to take these jobs, and they will be housed at the local university, where the local university has just so happened to be telling people, this is such a good idea, you have to have this corporation here. So how much money are the Chinese going to give the local university?
And Gretchen Whitmer, who strikes me as extraordinarily corrupt. I mean, someone got paid for this. Do we know who?
Well, we need to find that out. But obviously, lots of people are involved in this. You have lawmakers on both sides of the aisle, but you have Gretchen Whitmer. And we have said from the very beginning, this is suspect. And now you have the community rising up. So Big Rapids actually said, you know what? We don't want this in our town. We want this to move out. Goshen said, we're going to move to the town next door. They're still pushing. You still see local people coming up and saying, this does not make sense for us. We don't want the arm of the Chinese Communist Party right here in our small town. But think about this. This is truly an organization. It clearly states it has to be the Chinese Communist Party setting up in the middle of the country. You're surrounded by Wisconsin has an Air Force base. You have a lot of opportunity to spy on the United States if you're right in the center of the country. And they're writing, clearly stating that they are spying on the United States.
There are serious long-term problems facing America, as we've told you about for years on the show. Thanks to outsourcing, this country no longer has the same reserve of stable middle-class manufacturing jobs we did even 30 years ago. In coastal cities, housing has become astronomically expensive. Prices are rising far quicker than wage growth. And most tragically, an opioid epidemic kills tens of thousands of Americans every year. One of the chief reasons for that is a synthetic opioid called fentanyl gets smuggled in from abroad. Now, these might seem like unrelated problems, but they're not. A single theme unites them. A systematic decision by many of our country's most powerful leaders to sell out America to China. Those jobs that were outsourced, they went to China. Those rising home prices, all cash Chinese buyers are a major contributor to that, though it's almost never said out loud. Fentanyl, made in China, with the knowledge and tacit approval of the Chinese Communist Party. China is no longer simply an economic rival to the United States. It's becoming a dangerous enemy. But instead of protecting us from this threat, an existential one, our leadership class collaborates with the other side. Why do they do that? Simple, they're getting rich from it. This only became clear to many people a few months ago when the most American of all sports, professional basketball, a game literally invented in a gym in Springfield, Massachusetts, ripped off the mask and showed the world who really controls the league. NBA general manager Daryl Morey, you'll remember, wrote a tweet supporting pro-democracy protesters in Hong Kong. In the resulting backlash, the NBA and Morey both apologized for daring to criticize China's fascist regime. And then LeBron James weighed in and explained to us that actually freedom of speech in America is vastly overrated.
So many people could have been harmed, not only financially, but physically, emotionally, spiritually. So just be careful what we tweet and we say and what we do, even though, yes, we do have freedom of speech, but there can be a lot of negative that comes with that too.
ZTE, what's ZTE? Well, ZTE is so dangerous to American interests that last August, the president signed a bill banning the federal government from using that company's equipment because it's too threatening. But he's lobbying for it. Former Congressman Rick Boucher, meanwhile, has lobbied for a whole list of Chinese companies, including Hikvision, Huawei, and the search engine Baidu. But China isn't content buying off our retired lawmakers. They're also targeting people who have jobs that matter right now. Last night on this program, we told you about a man called Yu Meng. He's the chief investment officer at California's massive state-run pension fund called CalPERS. Meng, who was born in China and moved here at the age of 25, previously ran China's $3 trillion portfolio of foreign investments. CalPERS has long engaged in shareholder activism to advance left-wing causes in this country, like gun control, and been very aggressive about it. But now the fund also supports China's efforts to eclipse America. CalPERS invests in companies that supply the Chinese military, literally. They're also invested in Hikvision, which makes the surveillance equipment that China uses to monitor ethnic minorities like the Uyghurs. So they're actively abetting fascism. There's nothing harmless about these investments. As Yu Meng himself once noted, quote, of course it empowers the Chinese regime to have the money flowing in, end quote. Of course it does. But they did it anyway. When Meng worked for China's investment fund, he was recruited by the Thousand Talents Initiative. That's a Chinese program designed to encourage foreign businessmen, scientists, and other experts to work on China's behalf, often secretly. The explicit goal is to obtain Western technology and research for China's own use so they can surpass us, which they are. Last month, Harvard chemistry professor Charles Lieber, the head of the department, was arrested for hiding his work on behalf of China. In effect, Lieber was working as a spy, but his case isn't special. The entire sleazy academic world, and it's one of the sleaziest, is addicted to Chinese money. Harvard and Yale both stand accused of hiding hundreds of millions in donations from payments from foreign countries. Needless to say, China is one of the top contributors. Recently, the Texas A&M University System tried to gauge how many of its faculty were getting Chinese money. More than 100 of them had been recruited, it turns out, but only 5 had reported their work for a hostile foreign government. How many were indicted? You guess. Oh, yeah, 0. Now, Chinese officials aren't paying these academics because they love scholarship. No. America's universities are key centers of scientific research and technical innovation. China would like to steal that information, and they are. As of tonight, the FBI is investigating more than 1,000 cases in which they believe China has stolen research from American firms. If anything, our top colleges and universities are encouraging this to happen. And you can see it by the way they recruit. Chinese grad students fill our research labs. This makes college administrators much richer, but it also allows the Chinese government easy access to critical information, some of it that directly bears on our national security. American academics have made it clear whose side they're on. Last November, officials at the University of Missouri, Kansas City, removed an artistic display supporting protesters in Hong Kong because Chinese students complained. According to the New Republic, Columbia University's Global Center in Beijing canceled talks because they might upset Chinese officials. They're squelching free speech at the direction of communist China. And that's common in the business world. Disney changed its Tibetan character in one of its movies into a European woman because acknowledging Tibet's existence would anger their masters in China. They should be ashamed. Gap apologized for selling a t-shirt in Canada that didn't feature Taiwan as part of China. By the way, it's not part of China, but China demanded that Gap pretend it is, and they complied. We could go on. There are endless examples of this kind of thing. It's happening all around us. So how about Michael Bloomberg? He's running for president. Maybe more than anyone in America, Bloomberg represents the beliefs and values of our current aristocracy, which is by far the worst in American history, the stupidest, the most greedy. Not surprisingly, Bloomberg has both kowtowed to the Chinese and gotten rich from the Chinese. He's not embarrassed by it. In 2014, Bloomberg explained that actually, China's unelected leader isn't really a dictator.
The Communist Party wants to stay in power in China, and they listen to the public. When the public says, I can't breathe the air, Xi Jinping is not a dictator. He has to satisfy his constituents or he's not going to survive.
He's not a dictator?
No, he has a constituency to answer to.
The Chinese dictator is not a dictator. It makes you wonder how Michael Bloomberg would govern as president, or maybe it explains how he'd govern as president. The scariest part is that as China has grown more powerful, America has grown more dependent on it. Outsourcing our manufacturing power brought American companies big short-term profits. Head to Florida and you'll see the houses they built with those profits. But in the long run, that decision made this country dangerously dependent on a nation that seeks to displace us on the world stage. Consider just one small sector of the American economy, medical supplies. China is now a top producer of antibiotics, surgical tools, prescription drug ingredients, face masks, and many more essential products that you need to stay alive. 80% of our antibiotics right now come from China. Hard to believe, but true. The coronavirus panic alone was enough to cause shortages of some of these materials. What'll happen if an even bigger crisis comes along, as it inevitably will? Or what if China simply cuts off exports as